trusting your own process that you're going to get to something that you know will work because of the experience you've built up, but also trying to keep that aperture and possibility that you might do something you've never even considered before. And then feeding into that from the sides is influence from all the things you've ever seen and read and experienced. So another really important part of a creative process is to constantly see other people's work. Be aware of what everyone else is making. To always be looking, you know, if you are going to be fragmented on your phone, at least make sure you're following a whole load of creative practices so that you know who's making what's happening in the world, who's ever made what. Take every opportunity to go to a gallery to, I mean, if ever you're invited anywhere in the world for work, for whatever it is that you're invited to do, make a rule to yourself that if you're going to travel, if you're going to, you know, release the carbon emissions in your travels, just make sure it was worth it. Make sure you went to the art gallery. Make sure you visited, you know, the majestical local environment. Make sure you visited that mountain. Make sure you went to that theatre, whatever it is, and draw into your, you know, into your library of things that you've seen, experienced, the work of those other artists and, you know, times and places. The older I get, the more I feel this, is to not second guess what you might make. Go into each piece going, I have no idea what this is gonna be, it could be anything, and try to maintain that sense of freedom and possibility for as long as you possibly can.